In this video, we're going to look at how we go about calculating a specific physical property given the value of a specific partition function. So we're going to do this specifically for the average energy for the partition function of a collection of ideal gas particles. So our partition function for this system, Q, is going to depend on the number of particles, N, volume V, and inverse temperature, beta, where we remind ourselves that beta is just 1 over the Boltzmann constant times temperature. And this partition function, I'm not going to derive it. We're going to look a little bit later into why this is the form that it is. But we have volume to the number of particles over number of particles factorial times the quantity 2 pi mass of a single particle divided by Planck's constant squared times beta. And this entire term will be taken to the power of 3 times number of particles over 2. Okay, so that's our total partition function for a collection of n ideal gas particles. So for n ideal gas particles. All right, now the energy is going to depend on a specific derivative of this partition function. We said that the average energy, or its expectation value, is going to be equal to the minus partial derivative of the natural log of the partition function with respect to inverse temperature beta that it depends on. And that partial derivative at constant number of particles and volume. So the next thing we need to calculate in order to keep moving here is going to be the natural log of our partition function. So the ln of Q is going to equal the natural log of this whole thing. So not rewriting out the whole thing, I'm going to separate these out into some different parts just so that we keep things clear about what we're focused on. And we know that the natural log of a product of two functions is equal to the sum of the natural logs of those two values in that product. So this is going to be natural log of v to the n. And then if you're on the denominator, it's minus, because you have a power there of n factorial to the minus 1. So minus log n factorial. Then this here I'm going to split up into two different terms, plus log of 2 pi m over h squared to the 3n over 2. And then I'm going to keep the last term depending on just beta by itself, log of beta to the 3n over 2. But then let's remember also that when we have a power here for the argument of our logarithm, that can be pulled in front of the log. So this log v to the n can be written as n log v. And similarly, the thing that we're really interested in is we have this log of q is going to be dot dot dot, same three terms here, plus, or more likely minus, minus 3n over 2, we take out in front, times the natural log of beta. And that's the only term that has any beta dependence. So now, when we take the natural log, when we take the derivative with respect to beta, that partial derivative of log q with respect to beta is going to equal that derivative of minus 3n over 2 times log of beta plus a bunch of other terms without beta dependence. So these other terms don't have beta in them, so differentiating with respect to beta is just going to give us 0 for all those other terms. The only term of interest is this one right here. So if we take that derivative of log beta with respect to beta is 1 over beta, and it carries a factor of minus 3n over 2 out front. So this is going to be minus 3n over 2 beta. And now the minus of that is going to be our expectation value for our energy. So writing that up here, we have the expectation value for the energy is just going to be equal to minus sign in front of here, minus times minus gives us a plus, 3n over 2 beta. And reminding ourselves that beta equals 1 over Boltzmann constant times temperature, 1 over kbt, then 1 over 1 over kbt is just kbt. So this quantity is going to equal 3 halves n kbt. All right, so we have the Boltzmann constant, we have the number of particles, and we have the temperature. So the energy is directly proportional to the temperature. It's directly proportional to the number of particles, and it also has a numerical factor in there of 3 halves times the Boltzmann constant. So the Boltzmann constant, again, comes up as kind of an energy scale for kind of expressing a scale of how much energy there is per particle. Every particle for every degree Kelvin it has 3 halves the Boltzmann constant worth of energy there. And also remember that our number of particles is just equal to the number of moles times Avogadro's number, and the Boltzmann constant is equal to the gas constant R divided by Avogadro's number. So in fact, we have through these two relations here that number of particles times Boltzmann constant equals number of moles times gas constant. So for our final expression here, we can actually write that the energy, the average energy in a collection of ideal gas particles is going to be equal to 3 halves number of particles times Boltzmann constant times temperature, and it's also equal to 3 halves number of moles times gas constant times temperature. Those two expressions are completely equivalent, and we see how they relate between the microscopic of seeing what an individual particle does to the macroscopic of seeing what a whole mole of gas does, given these various relations here between the gas constant and the Boltzmann constant. And then if we want to take this one step further, energy is going to be an extensive property. It scales with number of moles, as we see there. If we want to calculate the average molar energy, so molar energy is the energy in 1 mole of particles, that would also be written as E bar, and internal energy, which this is also going to be seen as later as we delve more into classical thermodynamics, also expressed as U bar, where E, the regular energy, and internal energy are equivalent depending on whether you're viewing them from a microscopic or a macroscopic level. So we have that our E bar, or our U bar. E bar is just going to be defined as E divided by number of moles. So that's how we get the number of, that's how we get the energy per mole of substance, is we take the energy and we divide it by the number of moles. So if we take this up here and we divide by the number of moles, that's pretty straightforward because we already have N right there. So 3 halves NRT divided by N is just going to give us a final molar volume of 3 halves RT. And that's a pretty famous relationship in physical chemistry, that the molar energy of a monatomic ideal gas, so an ideal gas particle, which is a single atom, that its energy is 3 halves times the gas constant times temperature per every mole of substance. So that's something we're going to see later in macroscopic thermodynamics, and we see using the partition function here that it falls out very naturally once we have this partition function and we derive our physical properties using the relationships and the various derivatives of the partition function that take us there.